This is differential pulse code modulation and demodulation trainer. Order code of this trainer is 40514. You can see on the panel, different block diagram are provided. This is audio frequency oscillator. Range of this oscillator is 10 Hz to 100 Hz. This is AF oscillator. And output of this oscillator is available between these two terminals. AF output, this is ground terminal, this is positive output. This is the frequency variable knob. You can adjust the frequency of audio frequency oscillator with the help of this knob. 10 Hz to 100 Hz, you can vary the frequency with the help of this knob. This is variable DC voltage, minus 5 volt to plus 5 volt. And output of this section is available between these two terminals. This is DC output terminal. You can adjust the output voltage with the help of this knob. This is voltage adjustable knob. When you put this knob fully anti-clockwise, output of this section is minus 5 volt. When you put this knob to fully clockwise position, then you will get the output of this section, DC output, plus 5 volt. This section is differential pulse code modulator section. Different blocks are provided for the study of procedure of differential pulse code modulation. The terminals are for audio frequency input. You can feed the audio frequency from audio frequency oscillator to these terminals. This is positive terminal and this is ground terminal. This is a terminal for differential output. You can observe the output, differential output at this terminal. These terminals for sampling signal. You can observe the sampling signal to connect CRO between these two terminals. These terminals are differential pulse code modulator output named DPCM output. So you can observe the DPCM output, connect the CRO between these two terminals. This block is for analog to digital converter, and then parallel to serial converter, and this block is for DPCM demodulator, differential pulse code demodulator. Input of this section is DPCM input. These terminals are for the input. You can feed the input to this section from these terminals, DPCM output, which is already connected. This line indicates DPCM output terminal is already connected to DPCM input. You can observe the input signal which is given to DPCM demodulator section. This is D2A output, digital to analog converter, output of digital analog converter. This is your digital to analog converter block, and output of this block is available between these two terminals, D2A output. And after these terminals, the output goes to integrator, summer, and finally is available at the AF output terminals. You can observe the audio frequency output between these two terminals. This is the demodulated output, which you can observe with the help of oscilloscope. So these are the different blocks on the panel. Now we are going to do experiment on this trainer. Apply the variable DC signal to the input terminal of DPCM modulator, AF input. These terminals are AF input terminals. So you can connect ground to lower terminal of variable DC voltage section and upper terminal, that is positive terminal to the upper terminal of variable DC voltage section. Now your variable DC voltage section is connected to AF input terminal of DPCM modulator section. Observe the sampling signal on one channel of dual trace CRO. This is your dual trace CRO. You can connect the first channel of this CRO to sampling signal output. This is your sampling signal output. You can observe the sampling signal between these two terminals. So connect the CRO, black lead to ground, red lead to upper terminal. Now sampling signal output is connected to CRO. Switch on the unit. You can observe the sampling signal. This is your sampling signal output. This is your sampling signal. Observe the output of differential pulse code modulator section. These are the output terminals of this section. This is differential pulse code modulator section output, and connect this output to second channel of CRO. Now DPCM output is connected to another channel of CRO. By adjusting the DC voltage potentiometer, we can get the DPCM output from 00. This is your 00 output. This is sampling signal, and this is channel second, which is connected to DPCM output. Now you can vary the DC adjustable knob and see the effect of DC voltage on second channel of CRO. This is first channel waveform and this is second channel waveform, and your second channel is connected to DPCM output terminals. So by varying the adjustable knob, which is in variable DC voltage section, you can see the effect of DC variation at the output terminal, at the output waveform of DPCM modulator section. Now we are rotating the DC adjustable knob to anticlockwise direction. Anticlockwise direction means to minus 5 volt. And these are the outputs of differential pulse code modulator section. We are rotating the DC variable knob to anticlockwise direction. Now this is in fully anticlockwise. Now we can rotate it to clockwise direction, and we are rotating it to clockwise direction. Clockwise direction means plus 5 volt direction, maximum side to maximum side. And this is fully clockwise direction, means plus 5 volt. So you can observe the different outputs of modulator DPCM modulator section with the help of this variable DC knob. Now disconnect the DC voltage and apply audio frequency oscillator and to the input of differential pulse code modulator section. This is your audio frequency oscillator. Connect AF output terminals to CRO and observe the waveform of AF oscillator. This is your AF output. You can adjust the frequency of this oscillator with the help of frequency adjustable knob. Now this frequency adjustable knob is in maximum position. Maximum position means fully clockwise position, and the waveform of output is shown by the oscilloscope. Now we are rotating it to minimum position, anti-clockwise position. And this is the output of AF oscillator. Range of frequency 10 Hz to 100 Hz. This is low frequency, so you are observing the waveform as a blinking signal. Low frequency, because of low frequency blinking is there. So apply this audio frequency output to AF input. These terminals are for AF input. So apply the audio frequency oscillator to AF input. Ground is already connected. You can also connect the ground to ground terminal. Now your audio frequency oscillator is connected to differential pulse code modulator section. Observe the output. So this is the output. This is the output of differential pulse code modulator section for audio frequency input. Audio frequency oscillator is connected to audio frequency input terminal of differential pulse code modulator section, and the output of differential pulse code modulator is shown by the oscilloscope, and you can see, you can vary the frequency. You can vary the frequency of audio frequency oscillator and see the effect of this frequency variation on the output of differential pulse code modulator section. So this is the output of differential pulse code modulator. Now we are going to observe the digital to analog converter output. This DPCM output, differential pulse code modulator section output, is already connected to DPCM input terminal of demodulator section. These are the terminal of input terminal of demodulator section. You can observe the input signal by connecting the CRO between these two terminals. So this is the same signal which is available between the DPCM output terminals and DPCM input terminals. So we are going to observe digital to analog converter output by the connecting the CRO cable between D2A output terminals. So for the better, for the clarity of waveform, you can adjust the frequency of audio frequency oscillator . This is digital to analog converter output, and this waveform is also shown in our manual as a figure 6 waveform. You can see this waveform in our manual, and CRO is also showing the same waveform. Because of the low frequency, blinking is there. Now connect the CRO on AF output terminal. These terminals are audio frequency output terminal. These terminals are the output of modulator section, final output of modulator section, demodulator section. So this is your demodulated output. This is your demodulated output, received signal, received modulating signal. You can observe the input signal with this received signal by connecting the another channel of CRO at the terminal, output terminal of audio frequency oscillator by keeping the alternate mode. So this is your input terminal, output of AF oscillator, and this is your received signal, output of demodulator section. So you can study the both signal, both sine wave with the help of CRO. Because of the low frequency, waveform is blinking, and so this is the differential pulse code modulation and demodulation trainer. You can study the different block, different procedure, whole procedure of pulse code modulation, differential pulse code modulation and demodulation with the help of this trainer. Order code of this trainer is 40514. Thank you.